Hey guys, happy summer. Today is June 1st, so I thought, sorry, I'm like literally getting ready in the car because, you know, if you've watched my vlogs in the past, you know that I'm kind of chaotic and I'm running late for everything all the time. So I am currently running, literally I'm supposed to be at the hair salon like right now, and luckily it is right by my house, but my girl just texted me and said that she's running a few minutes late. So I am literally putting on my makeup in the car because I feel like when you go get your hair done, you just gotta go looking like your everyday self, you know, like look put together so that when you see it when it's all, when everything's put together. So does that make sense? Does anyone else, or are you the total opposite where you're like, no, I want to look good and feel good even with makeup off? I don't know, but I'm the type that I'm like, no, I need to go in with a full face of makeup so I can get the full effect. But we're actually doing something completely different. We're adding color and dimension, and I'm thinking about chopping maybe not chopping off, but cutting quite a bit off. So let's head to the salon and give her a little fixer-upper. I actually don't even think I finished my thought. I meant to say it is June 1st and we're starting our summer diaries again, and I am planning to vlog weekly, if not every other week. I'm not like pushing myself to do it weekly, but I am making this more of a priority over Instagram and TikTok, just because YouTube is truthfully the platform that I started on and like kind of wanted to grow on first, and then put it on the back burner because TikTok and Reels were trending. But I don't know, I was like, you know what, stick with your gut, Mallory, do what you wanted to do originally and just chase a dream that you've literally dreamed about since you were 10 years old. So that's what we're doing. We're starting off strong. It's June 1st. We're headed to get our hair done for our summer diaries. Just a little summer glow up series and all the fun stuff, because I do fortunately live on an island, so there is a lot of cool things for me to do and vlog in the summer on top of just, I don't know, me taking this a little more seriously. So I'm gonna get back to driving. Notice I am looking at the road. I am not looking at my camera, but I am talking to you guys, and I should probably focus on that before, you know. Anyway, so headed to the salon. I'm really excited to vlog this because I'm also shooting content for the salon on Monday, so I could probably take you guys behind the scenes on that, because I am shooting content for them and kind of like testing out lighting today while I'm getting my hair done. I'm super excited. The girls who work at the salon are amazing, and the salon itself is super pretty and aesthetic, and just, I'm really excited for them. This is gonna be really great.
Do you want the other side?
Oh, but no, the lighting's good. I'm like, that. The lighting's good.
The lighting is good.
Okay, we'll just move it. No, this one I've actually had for, since COVID. I bought it during COVID.
Really?
When I originally wanted to start YouTube.
That's super cool.
And then got shy. It's like, people are gonna make fun of me.
No, during COVID we all just had ideas.
Yeah. I filmed a bunch of stuff during COVID, but it wasn't until recently that I was like, I don't care what people say.
So I feel like right now it's like dark and then all one color.
Mm-hmm.
I almost feel like if we do balayage, it's gonna break up the colors, and you're gonna have this color in between, and it will add dimension. Or we can do the balayage and do low light, so it deepens the color in between, so it's not so light. So that's gonna end up being more colors in your hair.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, more work, but it's not. I mean, it doesn't matter. But I'm just wondering, like, the grow out, if you're gonna like it. And more color, more damage. More everything. I feel like balayage is meant to be, like, natural, and then kind of add some blonde that comes up right here, and just kind of lower it right here.
Yeah.
Kind of like in that picture, she has like the deep color right there. Mm-hmm. What are you thinking?
No, it's kind of all over my head.
Because that picture is so, I mean, that hair is definitely doable. Mm-hmm. It's just like where you're starting from
right.
with the lightness already mm-hmm. and then the dark. And the other thing we're probably going to run into is this is going to turn lighter than up here.
Mm-hmm.
So I might have to like tone it darker up here and then lighter at the end. So it's going to be dark to like kind of light.
Yeah, I trust you. I just like that color.
The honey.
Uh-huh.
And it's going to be mostly the toner that's going to help with the honey.
Okay.
But if we leave this color in between, you're still going to have probably a little bit of this color. Because I'm going to have to
That's okay, it. Yeah. I mean, if there's a little bit peeking through, I think it'll be pretty and it'll look like we added more color.
Do you want more dimension or overall, like, lightness? I mean, the overall lightness is going to still be dimensional, but...
Maybe that then. Because I'm
going to make it look like almost like... It's still going to have dimensions, but it's going to be more like one color. Or I can do smaller sections and make it more dimensional.
Mm-hmm. I think I'm just like ready for a big change.
Okay. Don't we just kind of go for it?
Sure.
Okay.
I love that. So the lighting is not gonna do it justice in here like at all, because you can kind of tell, but it is like 8:15. I got here at 2:30. This took way longer than we expected, but totally worth it. She knocked this one out of the park. So I'm gonna go home, eat dinner. We're gonna resume this vlog tomorrow and I will show you guys in better light what it looks like tomorrow. Okay. So this is the hair in better light. My lighting on my G7X is a little weird. And if I sound a little nasally, for whatever reason, right after my haircut, I got home and was like, what is in the air? Like, I felt so sick. But here is the hair and a little OOTD. We are running errands, so I just put on something comfy and cool because it is like full-blown summer here in Texas. It's absolutely insane. So. We're gonna go run some errands. Reed's actually going out of town this weekend, so we're gonna go pick up some golf balls because he is going golfing this weekend. And pick up some shoes because Maddox is growing like a literal weeb. How, like, okay, this lighting doesn't do it justice, but I love how when you find your right shade, like what it does to your complexion and your eyes and just like brightens up the features of your face. Like I said, the lighting here isn't great. The G7X has amazing quality, but sometimes I don't know, I can't tell on this camera, so hopefully like when I upload it it'll look better. But I'm just like, wow, she hand painted this balayage and it looks absolutely amazing. Okay, so one of my goals this summer is to pick up pickleball, but I don't like any of these here, so we're gonna get some off by Amazon because they're much cuter and cheaper. These are so cute.
Then we're going to the restroom. The line might be 40 people deep, so Reed's waiting in line while I go really quick, because usually I wouldn't go. I just wait till we get home, but I'm like, I'm not gonna make it. And I actually have no idea where the restroom is, so I'm kind of lost. Looks like I'm gonna wait till I get home because I have no idea where the restroom is. And it's so crowded, it's insane.
God, your husband's hot. Can I get a supper?
I'm keeping that in the video. I said I'm gonna keep that in the video.
That's fine, it already happened to me yesterday at the store.
I'm getting mad because he's cute.
morning.
Ish.
I think it's like 9:45.
I am already dressed and ready for the day. We are doing a photo shoot for the salon. I had hair day, what day was it? On Saturday, and then today's Monday, we're doing a photo shoot for the salon that I go to, and doing some like headshots, lifestyle, getting some social media content for them, and I'm super excited because I'm still kind of new to the area that I'm living in, and I have become pretty, like, I would say pretty good friends with my hairstylist. She's really cool. I really enjoy hanging out with her, and was like, hey, I want to open my photography business back up down here because we did move 400 miles away from where my business started. And so I was like, I don't know many people down here, but hey, will you be my guinea pigs? Let's do a photo shoot for you guys and get you some social media content. Because I am no longer teaching. I thank God that chapter has closed. We can do a little tea time later on that one. But until then, just know that I'm not doing that anymore and am trying to pursue social media full time, as well as reopening my photography business and diving more into the social media manager world. So hopefully today all goes well, which I know it will. Like, I'm just like so ecstatic for this. I've been thinking about doing this for quite some time and just finally pulled the trigger and had enough time. So Maddox is at school, Reed is at work. It is Monday morning. We are having a nutritious-ish breakfast. These are my gluten-free bagels. It's an everything bagel with my dairy-free cream cheese. So if you haven't been following me and you don't know me, my dog just jumped the fence. Hang on.
Okay, so that was fun. My nice little sit-down breakfast turned into
stuffing my face as we walk out the door because we are running behind now. That is literally the third time this week. Today's Monday. That's the third time in the last like 3 days that she's done that. I have no idea why. The first time, I do know why. There was a storm coming in and it freaked her out, so she literally jumped the fence and ran away. But other than that, I think today she just saw something she wanted to chase. I literally saw her out her window jump over the fence, and I was like, okay, I quite literally don't have time for this. So, headed to the salon. I'll bring you behind the scenes a little bit on that. So, let's go. I've got to be there in 10 minutes. Luckily, it's about 10 minutes away from my house. So, let's go. I think before I got interrupted, I was talking about how I'm not teaching anymore and how we'll have tea time on that later. And, like, I'm planning to just do social media full time and then bring my business down here from Fort Worth and really, like, emphasize on the social media aspect of it and branding type photography. Like, I'll still do portraits because everyone loves having their portraits taken at the beach. Like, it's just, I'm sure in the summer my business will be booming, but something to bring a little more income that I can make my own schedule and really just do something I'm more passionate about. That way I could spend more time with my family. Like, I know I'm going to be working probably later at night when everyone goes to bed, but that means I can be more present during the day when I'm not working and can pick and choose, like, hey, let's do this on a day that I'm available, you know what I mean? And then, like, of course, working in people's schedules if they're here on vacation. But I don't know, it's something that I've been thinking about for a long time, and something that even when I went to college I knew I wanted to be an entrepreneur and not a teacher. And after, I don't know, I guess 5 or 6 years it's been since I graduated and started teaching, it's not for me, and I'm okay with that. For a while, I was more upset with the fact that, like, I spent all this time to go be something that I thought I wanted to be, and I ended up hating it, which I'm like, you know what? Thank you, God, for showing me that this is not for me in my 20s, and I'm not, like, 40 years old thinking, like, why did I waste my entire life doing something that I hated when I know my passions and I know my talents and my gifts and the things that I'm good at, and I'm stuck behind construction trucks right now. Oh my gosh. Okay, they're waving me along. So anyways, wow, I got so sidetracked. Squirrel. I mean, that is literally how my brain works. But another reason that education just wasn't for me. Like, I love kids and I loved being a teacher. I think I was a great teacher,
I just wasn't a great employee for the education world, if that makes sense. Because there's so much more than just teaching that goes into it that I didn't care for. And there was a lot of politics and a lot of drama. And again, I'm gonna do a whole, like, maybe we'll do a get ready with me sit down as to why I left education. And I will never go back. Like, I probably won't be in another classroom again until Maddox is in school. And if they ask me to be a room mom, it really honestly depends on who his teacher is and how, I don't know. We'll see. But anyways, I'm gonna continue driving. Okay, so of course my camera did die as soon as I said that. I don't even know if I got cut off or not, but awkward angle with my phone. Oh my gosh. Because we are here now at the salon. Holy cow. Can I not? Okay. We're gonna do a little tasty test of my Alani because I've never had these before. Sorry for the weird angle. This is so not aesthetic, but little ASMR. If you can hear it over the air vents. And I just brushed my teeth, so actually I don't know if this is gonna taste good. No, she does. Holy cow. This is a dangerous obsession that has now started. 200 milligrams of caffeine, and I've already had coffee, so pray for me. Good luck, Charlie, am I right? Fun. We're actually now going to eat, which is really fun. So I meet some friends and I'm really excited. These photos turn out so good, which hopefully by the time I'm posting this, I will be able to share on screen. Actually, I know I'm going to, so I'm just gonna go ahead and give you some little sneak peeks of how these turned out. I'm really excited to have this part of my business back open and just kind of go for a rebrand, which now I need to find myself a studio to shoot at so that I can do like a rebranding shoot for me and my business and just see where this takes me, because it was so good to get out and get behind the camera again and just kind of do something creative. And for like me, I used to stress about this so much, and I think it was because I was doing a type of photography that I didn't really enjoy as much. Like, there was once upon a time that portraits were a lot of fun for me, but being able to step into the branding and social media world, and we're just starting with a clean slate, and I think this is a really good rebrand for me. So let's go eat and then head back to the house. It is so hot here in Texas, but that was so much fun. We literally ate and sat and talked for like 2 hours, which is so nice. Love a girl's day like that. But it is now almost 4 o'clock, so I'm gonna go pick up Maddox from school. We might not be doing our nails until tomorrow, but I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I have had so much fun filming the past few days. I am planning to do these weekly just because it's summer. I'm taking social media like so seriously now. Like, this is my full-time job now, so I have more time to do it. I just feel like doing weekly vlogs is something that I have always wanted to do, and I'm probably just gonna film a separate, just like a dedicated nail tutorial for you guys, showing you how I do my nails at home. So other than that, if there's anything else y'all want to see moving forward, since this is now my full-time job, let me know. I do have an Amazon haul coming very soon. I've actually already started filming it. I am planning to do an updated summer Amazon haul. I hope you guys can hear me. It is super windy. I'm flying against the wind, and my Bronco does not like it. Have a great rest of your week or